liked the rail because it was a sort of character in a thriller that you don't see so often nowadays. It had a lot of Hitchcock in it, which I liked a lot. This everyday man whose life gets totally out of hands and have to deal with it.
He's a regular guy, who's a bit trapped within the life that he's living. He misses his train, he gets the next train, he meets this beautiful woman.
They immediately sort of plug into each other, and it's pretty hot, pretty fast.
By the time they make that decision to go to the hotel, they've kind of crossed that line of, I'm tired of giving for everyone else, and I want something for me.
There's a nice guy who's gonna get in trouble with very bad people, even better than what he thought at first.
Just take the money.
Chuck, I already took your money. You said this, this was your money, and I took it, now it's mine.
Things go from bad to worse to absolutely terrible, and they just keep spiraling. You know, he's in a bit of a sort of Kafka nightmare.
What I identified with was, I thought if I was in his shoes, I would be doing the exact same things, making the exact same mistakes, getting deeper and deeper and deeper into the hole as he does.
He's just trying to keep a grip on his life all the time, thinking, how did I get myself into this situation?
Rehearsal and action, please.
And it's a very reactive part. And you've got to keep finding interesting ways to represent that, because if you play the same note every time, it's going to get boring for me, for everybody.
Harvey Weinstein called me and said, why don't we go with Clive Owen? Both Michael and I, initial reaction is that's exactly the guy we've been looking for, in the sense of feeling like really a man and yet also having such depth of acting and the ability to convey vulnerability.
I mean, he's basically tall, dark, and handsome. There's just something that he brings to the screen that is undescribable. And you just want to watch him. There's just so much going on behind those eyes.
Charles has to be the everyman, so Clive is perfect for that. He just brings a real gravity to it, and he gets Charles so well.
I met Clive Owen very early on, and he was very enthusiastic. He read the script, and he really, really wanted to do it. Clive's energy and his feeling for this material was very strong, and I also had a very strong gut feeling for Clive and Jennifer as a couple.
So he called you?
I think we should go to the place.
No. No, Charles, you are not understanding me. I really had a good time kind of digging my heels into something sort of out of the box.
I think it's a great part for Jennifer, and you know, I was delighted when she expressed interest in doing it. It's a very different from what people would have seen her do before.
It's a very complex character. In a way, she's a classic femme fatale. She has a special sadness that I was looking for. But it was also important she should be extremely attractive, charming, and smart. And yeah, I couldn't find a better actress than Jennifer Aniston to do this part.
Everything she says, it sounds particular. You know, it doesn't come out like anybody else. She has her own timing. It's very interesting to watch, and of course very enjoyable to act with her.
Come on in. Don't be scared.
Philippe Laroche has two sides, really. From a very educated guy with a certain sense of humor, and on the other hand, a pretty scary person.
Keep those trailers.
Thanks, Charlie.
That's for canceling your credit card.
Vincent brings a lot of different dimensions to this character, which is very important for him.
He's frightening, first of all. He's utterly... He will send chills down your spine. He's fantastic.
I love to play baddies, and I do that in France too, but I always try to bring something where I could forgive the character for what he does.
Vince has turned out to be a real cool homie, you know? So, I mean, you spend a lot of time working on the set, and he's a real cool dude, you know? He's like my brother from another mother, you know, except he's from France. And he's got a cool accent, and I dope.
Well, my dear Dexter, I think it's time to relocate.
Yeah, relocate. Au revoir.
He's amazing, Exhibit. Well, first of all, he again looks like he could just take you down with one swipe of his palm. And he was terrified after every take that he was somehow hurting me. And he's just the sweetest guy on the planet, as mean as he looks in this movie.
I didn't do it.
Push the button right there.
Yeah, you see? They made me the scapegoat. They give me the only key to the car, all right?
Where I come from France, you tell people that you're gonna make a movie with Mikael Halfstrom, which Jennifer Aniston and Clive Owen, you know, or acting, and people go, yeah, right. And then you say, but there'll be the race and exhibit, and everybody go, what? Because from a certain point of view, where I come from, those are the real stars of the movie. It was just fun to be around those guys, you know, because I've been listening to their music for a long time.
Well, I thought it was the Major League or the Minor League. What's the National League?
What, you don't follow baseball?
Nah, man, hockey's my game. More goal, less ball, baby.
It's fun to kind of be somebody you ain't for a moment, you know what I mean? So I think that's what the beautiful thing about acting is, that any film you join, you're a whole different person. Whereas music, you gotta maintain and keep your identity.
I think the main thing on the movie is the director, and we have the chance of having Mikael Hafström.
He's an artist, and he has really focused on this love story in a beautiful way.
Mikael is not the kind of director that'll scream through a megaphone at you. He comes up to you and gives you real one-on-one direction, and you know exactly how he wants you in the film. You know, he speaks real softly. He's like,
exhibit, it is good, but we need more.
Yeah, I'm gonna stay right where you just be staring at him like this.
Yeah. I trust where he wants to take me as a character, because he seems very on top of the psychological journey of the character, but also the psychological framework of the whole movie.
It's even better if I'm still almost speaking than it would be if I've stopped speaking.
He's not going down the formula road of how a normal thriller would be shot.
Cut it! It's cut!
Derailed is a morality tale.
It may be a little bit like when you're driving a car and you get in a car accident, you just wish, you know, if I'd only gone a little slower, if I'd taken a left, kind of spellbinding.
What have you done?
I'm so sorry.
You want a gun, Mr. Sean?
Everything that happens in this movie is surprise after surprise.
It's dark.
I want everything you took from me.
Exciting. And derailed. Ha ha ha.